Hello guys, welcome back to CLGTart channel. It's nice to see you guys again. I kind of busy last few days, so I didn't make any videos. And I'm still taking the request, so if you have any questions, just put in the comment below and I will read all of them. So I will take note and film it whenever I have time, okay? So this video is gonna be a tutorial about how to blending in Firealpaca, because there's some you guys asking me about this. Actually, I didn't use Firealpaca. Yeah, it's kind of hard to name it. I didn't use this one very much. I prefer using Medibang more, because in Medibang they have the cloud with a lot of brush in here and the material, yeah. Because of that, and Firealpaca, they are kind of like Paintool Sai, yeah, the brushing key. You know that you can add brush from bitmap and script, and you will create a new brush here by changing the setting of this one, okay? Like create a new brush, and you will choose the type here, the add brush or the eraser or the watercolor, and the blur key. You can also use the blur. And I recommend you guys, if you want to make a blending brush, you can use the watercolor and fix the setting here until you satisfy with the result. And I must say that because the same as Medibang, the Firealpaca don't have the brush that for blending, they're just the brush. The same as other brush, you will have the color on it if you just kind of mix this color together. So that's how it works here. Yeah, that's what I want to know, or I want to say to you guys. Okay, and you see that I find on the default brush in here, they have watercolor brush, and I'm changing a little bit about the setting. You can see on the screen right now, and they have the blur brush, and I found that the blur brush in Firealpaca kind of work better than Medibang. You know, the blur in intensity here works stronger than Medibang. And you also have the flat brush in here. I'm changing the setting a lot here. You can see the setting, I change it. You can drag it in here to change it to this one until you satisfy with the product. And yeah, this is the new brush I just create, and I still didn't put the name for this one, so it has no name. And the tie is watercolor, and you see that is missing color. I choose 89 and load color is 0 because I don't want the color appear much when we blending. That's why. Okay, so that is the 4 brushes I will use when I blending. That's it, the watercolor for basing color, base color, and kind of make some soft strong color. And the flat brush here that I will use when I want to have some part that have the sharp edge, kind of like this. Blur brush is a place that I want it look kind of soft. Sometimes you can switch to airbrush, but I didn't prefer this one, so that's why I didn't use that one. And the new brush, no name here for blending. Yeah, okay. So I use again the characters in here to show you guys the example, because you know I just changing my computer and all of my work is gone. And here you will go back to the layer. This is layer 7 here. This is the base color I already have for the skin. And I create a new layer. This is layer 25 here, and choose clipping because I want to make the shadow color in here, blending color in the another layer, so I can go back even make a mask. Okay, now we'll go here first. I will use the watercolor brush and pick the base color. Let me resize this one. And you see that I will put the color in here. You see how strong it is. And because I'm changing the setting, so it look kind of soft and still have a little bit blending here. So how is blending? If the same as Medibang, and if you have enough skill, you can use this blending, and then you pick the base colors in here, yeah, and then drag from outside to inside just slightly. If you have welcome, that will be the best, and you just drag it slightly here. until you feel it kind of blending together. But if you don't have techniques, don't worry about it. You could just create a new brush, and that's why I created this brush here. And it works just the same, that you will pick the base color, draw outside to inside. The create design must be better for the area you work in. And this way I want to make this one a little bit stronger. Okay, so you see to see. Okay, here you see how it's blending, right? And if you think that is not enough, you can switch the colors in here to white. So drag it from outside to inside, you can see that the color is kinda lighter here, like this. Remember, drag it, not doing like this, because it will mix all the color together, and you just every stroke here, every stroke from outside to inside here, and it will create the blending look for this one. Okay, and if you want to erase some part, okay, that if you feel it blending too much, you can use the transparency here and drag slightly from outside to inside again, so it will erase some part you want to, like this one. So that is how it works for you when you're blending here. And in case that you want to make it look blurry, kinda not so soft, not too sharp, you can use the blur tool here. And if you find that, you can see that, sorry, go back here. If you think that it's not blurry enough, just drag a setting here with a higher number, so you can see how the blur working like this. So for you to easily to see, I will make an example in the white paper in here. So first, I will have the strong color like this. Then I will have the base color dragging from outside to inside. You see how it's blending. But it's not work, and you want to use that brush and just work the same. You can see how it's softer blending here. And just continue to drag it like this one. If you're not satisfied with this one, use the white one. You see how lighter it works, like this. And now, if you want to make it more blurry, use the blur tool here. If you find that it's not blur enough, here, not blurry enough as you want to, you just drag it with the higher number, and here is the result. Okay, so that is how it's blending in Firealpaca, and that's how I work with that one. But you know that you can maybe can find other setting and of the brush in from internet. Just shutter for it and create your new brush, your old brush, so you can do it blending and work perfect for you. Yeah, okay, like this. So now I will continue to blend again and create a shadow again for this character in here, and you can see the result of what I can do with the Firealpaca with blending and creating the skin color. So that's all. Thank you for watching, and goodbye. See you next time.